You know, I don't normally put my input on the polls in these videos, but they are polling whether or not they should add a hill giant boss. It's all I've ever wanted. Please vote yes. A Varax flail. See, it worked, man. I say good luck and nobody's here anyway. Definitely have plenty of those. You know, come to think of it, I feel like I actually don't have plenty of those. I'm kind of curious. I'm gonna head to the bank. At this point, the only item I'm missing is the Darox helmet, and I feel like I have a ton of Barrows items, but I feel like the flail is one that I don't have a whole lot of. Yeah, that's actually only my second one. Nobody's here. But I'm gonna say good luck anyway. The times that nobody's here and I say good luck is when I get items, I swear to God. There is an elite clue scroll on Barrow's chest 709. Let's go do it. Alright, we have ourselves an elite clue scroll casket. Let's see what it is. You cannot open a cat. Well, fuck me! Alright, let's try that again. Clinically depressed. This is too hype. My chat's already flying enough. Oh, we got a Guthan's chain skirt on Barrow's chest 717. Obviously a duplicate, not what I need, but another item to break up the dry streak. Mr. Mammal. K-Buff. Your dick is mad. Is that good? Like, is it? Do you want to have a mad dick or what? there's an elite clue scroll. Another one tonight, my second elite tonight on chest 718. I need to know, do I want a mad dick or what? Here we are again with another elite clue scroll. Last reward was pretty bad, but I got faith in this one. Alright, this fucking vulture's getting it. We call this teasing the noobs. Just a level 101 running around. Can't understand why bandos won't stop hitting her and they just stand there. Got him! No way! No way! I stood and waited for this team to finish on this world for like fucking half an hour. Totally worth the wait! Let's go! My first Bandos armor piece is the Bandos Tass that's unkilled 229. Oh my god! My heart is freaking pounding! Let's go, dude! Just got an attack level. I am currently hunting a Cerberus task. I have like 15 Slayer points right now, so I was kind of forced into doing Necreal, but we just got level 97 attack. 1.1 mil to a level, that's gross, but only a couple levels away from 99 attack, which is awesome. There it is! I just got so excited because I was mid-sentence anyway. Alright, cool. 167 Hellhounds, so there we go. There is my first Cerberus task with 91 Slayer. I've killed about 150 Cerberus while boosting with no luck, so this is my first official task of Cerberus without having to boost, and let's see if we can get some crystals. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Is that the one I need? Oh my dick, I think I actually just completed my Zamorak book. Did I actually? No! I could have swore page one was the one I needed. Oh, now I'm sad. What the hell? Wait. That level 82 in full rune just had a Cerberus pet. Did you catch that? What the fuck? So I did approximately 50 Cerberus kills tonight. As you can see, I'm up to 191 kill count. But I ran out of sharks, so now I'm here at Zulra, and I just got a new personal best of 1 minute and 42 seconds. I swear I just broke my PB last episode, and here we are. Even I was like 10 seconds faster, too. Alright, we are about to get level 78 farming, which means at this point I can now get a plus 5 boost and plant my spirit tree that I need for my master clue scroll. Now, one of my viewers told me that it actually takes like 2 or 3 days for a spirit tree to grow, so I'm gonna go plant that now, and I don't know, I hope it doesn't take that long to grow, but I guess we'll find out. So I am cooking some sharks right now for my Cerberus task, and I just got level 90 cooking, which is a crazy milestone. I can't believe I'm at level 90 already. I mean, I guess it's not that surprising, considering how often I need to make food for PVM and whatnot, but still pretty crazy. Just got level 90 cooking. There it is! My first crystal! Let's go! I actually didn't have the recorder on. I didn't expect this at all. Oh my goodness, we get the Eternal Crystal on Cerberus kill count 244. Obviously I was hoping for a Primordial, but that is awesome! So if you don't know, the Eternal Crystal is used to make the best magic boots in the game, so when this trip is over, we can go ahead and put these on our Infinity Boots. Okay, so I don't know if anything is required other than what I have. As far as I know, you just use the crystal in the boots, so... Are you sure you wish to infuse the Infinity Boots and the Eternal Crystal to create Eternal Boots? You're damn right I do! These are honestly some of the coolest looking boots in the game in my opinion, and they have amazing stats. Plus 8 magic bonus. Best magic boots in the game! I'm honestly so excited. I still have about 60 Cerberus left to kill, so we could still get more drops, you never know. Hey, there we go, there's another drop coming in. We got an Elite Clue Scroll on Cerberus kill count 258. Now, when I did this task, when I was boosting before, I think I got 3 elites in one task. So, it was kind of nice to get another one now after finally getting a crystal, but after this trip is over, we'll go do our Elite Clue Scroll. Alright, time for the Elite Casket. Pick up this Renard before I open it. I mean, for real though, that's a lot of summer pies. 40 of them? I'm not even mad, that's a... Holy shit. You're kidding me! No! I'm not gonna get it! No! Oh my fucking god! I just got an Eternal Crystal and died! No! Okay, listen. On the bright side, it's a duplicate, okay? You cannot be serious, though! I don't think I can make it back in time. I just gotta go. You cannot be serious right now! Oh my god! Imagine if that were a Pegasian or a fucking Primordial Crystal. I'd be so mad. So, Crystal number 2 is an Eternal Crystal on kill 271. And I died at the same time as Cerberus. Like I said, I'm just grateful that that wasn't like, say, a Primordial or something. I mean, that... At least I can see the humor in it because it was a duplicate, but wow, what are the odds of that shit? Okay, here comes the final Cerberus kill of the task. So obviously earlier we got 2 Eternal Crystals, although they only kept the one, and an Elite Clue Scroll, so... And what was that, 160-something kills? 2 Crystals and an Elite Clue Scroll, definitely cannot complain. My Cerberus kill count is now 307, so 2 Crystals and 307 kill count. I believe that's... A little bit unlucky in terms of drop rate, but I am obviously never going to complain. Well, now that I am done with my Cerberus task, I want to try out some new content that just came out today. They just released the Winter Tot, I think I'm saying that right. Basically, it's a skilling boss. So, it's really, really good fire-making XP per hour. I mean, obviously it's not faster than actually training fire-making the normal way. But it's pretty damn good fire making XP per hour. The rewards are really good. You get this cool looking fire making outfit. And I've been told, and I believe it was nerfed, but it still gives pretty good seeds and like raw sharks and stuff. So this actually could be pretty decent for my Iron Man account. But anyways, this just came out today. I'm going to try it for a little bit and I'll tell you what I think of it. Oh my god. Look at all these chop chops. What the hell? So... To my knowledge, all you do is chop these Bruma roots, you put them in the brazier, and that's about it. I don't know. And there we go. That is actually perfect timing. I just finished my first game. I got level 66 fire making and a reward crate. So let's see what I get out of the reward crate. Raw sharks. Okay, that's awesome. People weren't lying. You actually do get a lot of raw sharks. Cool. Okay, so crate number 2 is 9 raw sharks. I'm gonna guess I'm getting lucky right now and it doesn't actually give, like, raw sharks every time, but that's awesome. Alright, just got level 67 fire making. And we get dynamite and a runite ore. What the fuck? Alright, there it is, level 68 fire making, and we get two Renar seeds. Oh, that's awesome. See, this is what I was seeing, was people were getting like Renar and Snapdragon seeds. I don't know how much longer I'm gonna do this. I'll go for at least like 70 fire making, but I guess the rewards haven't been overwhelming. There is level 69 fire making. I'm sorry, when I record, these fuckers all run by, I lag a little bit. You get two uncut diamonds and a watermelon seed. I haven't had either of those yet. Just got level 70 fire making. That was actually my goal for this. I started at 65 and I want to get up to level 70. So this game is about to end. We'll see what my reward is. This is pretty awesome. I'm not going to lie. I'm 70 fire making right now, as you just saw, and I'm getting about 200k fire making XP per hour. And the rewards are decent. You know, I was hoping I would get more raw sharks and stuff than I have been getting, but it really isn't bad. And the fire making outfit's cool and all, so in my opinion, it's a pretty decent overall update. I definitely can't complain about it, so let's go ahead and open the last crate for now. Ooh, two use seeds. That's probably my most valuable crate, but I'm going to call that good for the day. Kind of wanted to try it out for now, but not a bad minigame at all. Bando's page 2. Pretty sure I have the book done, but whatever, it's okay. I'm going to use my new gear to fucking stab a scorpion. Holy shit, I'm an idiot! I don't have the band. That was the page I needed. I am an absolute dumbass. For whatever reason, I could have sworn I had the Bandos book done, but I actually didn't, and that was the one page I needed, so okay. If you're wondering where I got that easy clue scroll from, I got it while doing Bandos kill count, so holy shit, let me go to the lighthouse really quick. So there is another book. So wait, so have I actually done all of these other than Zamorak? You are kidding me. Arguably, the most useful book is the last one I have to get done, but there is another one completed. So we have all but the Zamorak book done. Okay, so after approximately 3 days of waiting, this damn spirit tree is finally grown. I mean, I guess they do give a lot of XP, so I understand why they take so long to grow, but damn, this is taking a while. 19k farming and holy shit. Oh my god. I thought the challenge was to check the health, and I just panicked. Oh, okay, never mind. So I need to teleport with this? Okay, 1 second. Okay, so let's do Port Sarim, and this should complete the challenge. Please? Okay, thank god it did. Let's go hand this back in and see what our next step will be. You have been given a new clue. You know, after all this waiting for the spirit tree, I feel like I deserve something easy. Okay, this could be good or bad. Okay, Fail of the Bard, I'm leaving for RuneFest tomorrow. I want to finish this clue before I end this video. Please, I literally beg you, just give me something easy so I can finish this clue. On this video, it can hold down a boat or crush a goat. This object you see is quite heavy. I have no fucking clue. Okay, so I am an absolute dumbass. The obvious answer is a barrel chest anchor. I don't know how I didn't think of that, but it's a barrel chest anchor, so there you go, Phalo. Please give me another easy clue. Muse Kill Reader. Grab me a Circle Legends Guild. Perfect. Here, solve this. Ooh, a puzzle box. Oh, there's a gnome child puzzle box. This game is just one big meme, I swear to God. This fucking gnome's face, I swear. Like, this dude has seen some shit. But anyway, there's that done. We are now on step number 5. Okay, these are not too terrible. I think I can do all of these. I just don't know the actual answers. Okay, there we go. Just found the third part of the clue scroll. And let's go ahead and take a look at what our next step is. Phalo the Bard once again. Oh, this makes me so nervous. Alright, here goes nothing. Please be something I can do. A book that preaches of some great figure, lending strength, might, and vigor. If it's a Zamorak book, I swear to God, dude. Well, I'm not 100% sure if it's any god book or the Bandos book in particular. Like, the one he said with the strength and vigor, it makes me want to say it's a Bandos book. And if that actually is the answer, I literally just finished this book earlier this episode, so that is some awesome timing. But, okay, that is the correct one. Let's see what our new clue is. Black Dehyde, a black dragon mask? I think I have that. I'm like 99% sure I have one of those. Oh, man. I'm so sad. I don't have a black dragon mask. I could have sworn I had like a million of these before. Oh, man. I guess it could be in my house. Let me go check. Well, unfortunately, this is where I need to wrap up the episode. If you guys are unaware, I am going to RuneFest this week. I'm recording this right now. It is actually the 12th, and I am leaving a little bit later today. So, of course, I need to get this video up before I go. This isn't as long as my normal progress videos, but if I don't upload this now, you're going to have to wait another whole week, and that is just... that'll be ridiculous. So, I want to start wrapping up the video here. Leave some feedback down below. What do you guys think? Do you guys think I should drop the Master Clue Scroll or not? Personally, I think I should drop the Master Clue Scroll simply because getting a Black Dragon Mask is 100% RNG based. Like, before I had the farming clue requirement, that I could grind out. But this, I may never ever get a Black Dragon Mask. So, I personally think I'm going to drop it, I guess. But leave some comments down below, should I drop it, yes or no? And with that, thank you all very much for watching the video today. Current total level is 1894, which is wild. We are super close to 1900 total level and 100 mil total XP. Let's go ahead and take my stuff off so I can look at my total bank value. Total bank value is a little bit over 400 mil, 405 mil. So even after Alchem the DFS, we are back over 400 mil. Big additions to this bank, I mean, you already know, the Bandos Tassets and the Eternal Boots on this episode, so I had some crazy luck and got some awesome drops on this episode, so I hope you guys all enjoyed the video today. Again, apologize, it wasn't exactly the longest video ever, but if you guys did enjoy it, feel free to hit that like button down below, and I will see you all soon.